Hi there, my name is Masrik, and today I'm going to be telling you a little bit about the science behind a glow stick. Alright, with a show of hands, how many of you could tell me what a glow stick is and what it does? Yep, just basic terms. Most of you, almost all of you, tell me just basically what a glow stick is. Now keep your hands raised. How many of you could tell me how it works, though? See, a lot of hands went down, which is fine. Before I did my research, I couldn't have told you how a glow stick works. I would have looked at it like, you bend it and it starts glowing, which is a common answer. Or a lot of little kids will say, oh, it runs on batteries, which we all know isn't true. There's no batteries in this. Alright, so what I hope to do today is to teach you a little bit about how the glow stick works, the science behind it. But I also, what I want to teach you is that there's some things in life that we know what they are, but not really how they work. And some of these things can be explained with science. Glow sticks are one of these things that I'll teach you today. So I'm going to start out by telling you the components of a glow stick. As you can see, a glow stick, just from looking at it, has an outer shell. This outer shell is flexible, it's plastic, and there's not really much to it. And there's an inner shell also, which is made of glass, which isn't very flexible because glass is very brittle. And there's chemical 1 and chemical 2 and a fluorescent dye. Chemical 1 is inside the glass shell, which is inside the plastic shell. And that's separated from chemical 2, which is surrounding that glass shell inside, and the fluorescent dye is mixed in with chemical 2. And so as these chemicals are sitting in here, look, I can shake it, I can do all this, nothing happens because chemical 2 and the fluorescent dye have no interaction together. But as soon as I crack that glass shell on the inside, you instantly see how you start to see that, and the more I crack it, the more chemical 1 starts to mix in with chemical 2 in the fluorescent dye, and you begin to see the light. You shake it up a little bit. Boom. You have the light. It's easier to see in the dark. See how bright that is. And that was just a little reaction between chemical 1 and chemical 2. And what happens is, when chemical 1 and chemical 2 come together, they combine, they have a reaction, and that reaction causes the fluorescent dye to become excited. And this causes the light to be emitted. And what this is called is a type of chemistry called chemiluminescence, which I don't expect any of you to know what that is, but what it is just light emitted as a product of a chemical reaction, which is what you're seeing happening in a glow stick. And the reason that glow sticks can be so beneficial is because there's no electricity in here. There's no batteries in a glow stick. So when you break it, it's just the chemicals reacting together. So that means that you could take this underwater, which is actually a very good use for it in scuba diving. A lot of scuba divers use it at night or in deep, dark areas where the light isn't as good. They bring this down with them, and it helps illuminate where they're going because there's no light down at the bottom of the ocean, and you can't really bring electricity with you. You can, but it's not as safe. But if you bring a glow stick, there's no risk of being electrocuted because all it is chemical reaction happening inside a tube. Another good use for glow sticks is emergency uses. So let's say the power goes out during a bad storm and you can't find anything to light, your flashlights, you don't have any flashlights, but you have glow sticks. These are good because once you crack them, they'll last for about 4 to 12 hours. You have a very large time span in which these will work, and they illuminate. Even though you can't really see me, you can kind of see, you can see where this is, and it helps make my outline as I go around. You can somewhat see my outline. This is good for the glow stick. And another use that I know all of you will like is safety on Halloween, which I know is coming up tomorrow for all of you kids, and I know you're excited. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pass out all... You each take a glow stick. Yep, feel free. Go ahead, break it. Hear that crack. You know that that crack is when the glass is breaking. And I want you all... I'll give you two. One you can crack and play with now, and I want you to take these out tomorrow. You bring them with you. And you can tell your friends, your parents, what you learned when you crack it tomorrow. Like, Mom, this is what happened. And you take them, and they'll keep you illuminated. You'll be safe from cars and people walking. It'll be a lot of fun. So I hope you enjoyed learning a little bit about how the glow stick works. But I also hope you learned that something as simple as a glow stick or other things in life can be explained through science. Thank you. Have a good day.